to our Lady for the extreme unity. Today's Mass intentions for the spiritual guidance of David Robertson, for the birthdays of Catherine Yvonne Figoso and Julita Villegas Lorenzo, and for the repose of the soul of Bea B. Vela and the Romualdo Castro.
I am all of the empire. I am heard by people high. All well and dark and free. My hand will stay. I made the stars of night. I made the darkness bright.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son Isaac, your only one, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a burnt offering, on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac and two of his servants as well, and with the wood that he had cut for the burnt offering, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go on over yonder. We will worship Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," he said. "Yes, son," he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the burnt offering?" "Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the burnt offering." Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on the top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing on him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by his horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering in place of his son. Abraham named the site Yahweh Yireh. Hence people now say, "On the mountain the Lord will see." Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did, in notwithstanding from me, your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of the enemies, and in your descendants, all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command." Abraham then returned to his servants, and they set out together for Beersheba, where Abraham made his home. The word of the Lord.
I will walk.
Concerned about
by our sweet heart, by our touch, by our helpfulness, that we can do something for the people who are suffering. And yes, in that suffering, they will be able to change and see wonderful things happening in their life. Jesus also goes ahead and not only cures them, but he forgives the sins. What a wonderful thing it is to forgive our sins. And that is what again our Lord is wanting from us, to forgive one another. And forgiveness as Jesus did, with gentleness, with patience, with understanding. Not with anger, hatred, or grudges that we hold on. Those things does not help us. What helps us is really to be loving, caring, and forgiving to one another. And when we have done that, yes, we can live in peace and harmony. We can understand each other. We can say to them, yes, you are my brother. Yes, you are my sister. And so we can work together in building up the kingdom of God. And Jesus has shown his compassion, his love for us. So also, let's do the same thing of showing compassion and love to one another. And with that faith that we have in Jesus, we all can be transformed, we all can be blessed, and we all can have the hope. In gratitude for what has been, in hope for what is will be, let us offer our prayers to God of life and joy.
For the church, that through its ministry people may experience the healing power of Christ in their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For Pope Francis, Archbishop Gomez, our regional bishop David O'Connell, and the bishops, priests, and deacons of this of our church, the lay ministry is being touched. The people they serve with compassion and understanding, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations and peoples of the world, that they may recognize, respect, and affirm the dignity of every person, made in the very image of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will turn our hearts to all the suffering people in the world, especially those who are helped by the Peter Spence Collection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of this community, that we may be aware of the power we have to live through a kind word or a thoughtful deed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the dead, especially those who are dear to us, that the Lord may awaken them to eternal glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will hear the intentions of our faith, community of our Lady of Guadalupe, and the prayers we now make in the silence of our hearts. And may these prayers be granted in accordance with the will of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you sent your Son into the world to heal our wounds of body, mind, and spirit. Help us to have complete faith in his healing power, and in your love for us, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
What do you want of me? Where do you want me to serve you? Where can I sing your praises?
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
You have saved us, please.
giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis the Pope, Jose Gomez, our bishop, and all the assistant bishops and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, us fathers, and with blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be forever to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. love Christ, keep him safe for the world.
Let us pray. By the power of this mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess in word and deed the faith for which blessed Junipus the Lord never ceased to labor, and for which he spent his whole life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks
be to God. And you have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Father.
Longing for life, we wait to God. Longing for truth, we turn to you.